Alabama in Bacon County said it was not tornado warned at that time, but it was spinning a little bit. It was rotating, and sure enough, that rotation has tightened up a little bit, and the National Weather Service office in Jacksonville has issued a tornado warning for this Bacon County severe thunderstorm. What is guaranteed here is also wind and hail. So I want to get right to the latest again, talk about where that tornado warning is in effect. It will, this storm itself, whether tornadic or not, will be impacting Wayne County as well over the next 30 to 45 minutes. Again, it is absolutely booking it off to the east and to the northeast. I know technically the tornado warning may not go all the way into Wayne County, but the storm responsible for that tornado warning is going to be tracking towards Scriven, and it is going to be tracking towards Jessup. And you can see the yellow polygon, a very large severe thunderstorm warning, is in effect producing this storm, even away from the tornadic portion. Wind gusts 50 to 70 miles per hour, hail from about P up to a quarter size. So let's zoom down in here. Again, the old saying is respect the polygon. If you live in or near this red polygon, you need to be taking your tornado safe precautions, moving into your tornado safe spot. Typically, that's going to be almost always in the centermost portion of your home. No windows on the lowest floor of your home. Generally speaking, put as many walls between you and the outside conditions. So New Lacey community, the Coffee community, this is the southeast side of Alma, east of US 1 and right along Georgia 32. We have a rotating supercell thunderstorm and it's moving off to the east northeast. So again, the community of Coffee, the community of New Lacey, not in the polygon yet, but Georgia 121 as you track towards Wayne County. That is going to be the next spot to watch. Also, the community of Rich, Georgia 203, getting deeper into Wayne County, and even southern Appling County here needs to keep an eye on this. Going to go ahead and bring you over to Farrah and Farrah First Alert Live Radar. This is the storm that we are watching embedded within this pink and purple and red shading right between Coffee and New Lacey. This is going to be the spot to watch, basically right on Georgia 121, tracking off to the east northeast. That'll put the community of Rich in the path of this dangerous thunderstorm, and anyone who lives along Georgia 203, maybe that transition to 121 and points south from there. So south and east of Alma, you are in the clear. The Bacon County seat there, you are in the clear. Guise, you are in the clear. Mm-hmm. From this particular rotating thunderstorm, we've been tracking this in the Weather Center, Andrew and Dave just off the screen here, talking about how the storm has been rotating for some time. The National Weather Service didn't quite pull a trigger on that warning. Now it's tightening up a little bit between New Lacey and Coffee, moving very, very quickly off to the east northeast. This storm itself has been moving 40, 45, and at times this morning up to 50 miles per hour. So now that we've kind of set the stage, going to hone in on the details here and look at what we have going on velocity wise, and we're going to have to jump down to our Jacksonville radar site. Actually, probably Valdosta may be the best option, Moody Air Force Base there. And it's not maybe a classic springtime setup where you always have greens next to reds. That hasn't been quite the setup today, though looking at this particular image, we do have some broad rotation right along Georgia 32, moving off to the north and to the east. And I'm going to zoom out just a little bit, and we're going to track this to the east northeast back into Wayne County, because I already want folks in Jessup to be aware you are not technically under this tornado warning over in Jessup, but this storm responsible for the warning has had a long history of producing hail and wind. In addition to this rotation all the way back into Atkinson County, Georgia, south of Douglas into Coffee County, and likely produce hail in Alma, southern Bacon County, and is now tracking off to the east and to the northeast. So I want to go ahead and track this out, moving northeast, or really east northeast, 45, 50 miles per hour. So we're going to track it in that general direction for about the next 48 minutes. Coffee community, within the next 3 minutes, it's basically there. You need to be in your safe spot. Coffee, Georgia, as many walls between you and the outside, centermost portion of your home, lowest floor of your home. Turn up the TV real loud and head into that closet. If you're a child who is home alone, maybe your parents running errands this morning, all you need to do is remain calm. Go to that centermost portion of your home, lowest floor. No windows in that room, so that's a laundry room, maybe a bathroom. A closet could work if it's in the centermost portion of your home. The important thing is center. of your home, not upstairs, but on that first floor, if you have a two-story home or something like that, and again, no windows, as many walls between you and the outside. By 12:35 or so, the community of Rich, 12:50, and it's over and approaching 1 p.m. within the next 45 minutes. It's moving rather quickly into Jessup. But remember, you need to be in your safe spot before that time. Technically Jessup, technically Screven, technically Slover, you are not under a tornado warning, but I just want to let you know, put it in the back of your head here, this storm is tracking your direction and will likely continue to remain severe here over the next 35 to 45 minutes. So bringing back what it looks like on radar right now, because this is kind of a multifaceted storm here. Not only is it obviously rotating, it has a history of producing damaging wind gusts, 50 to 70 miles per hour, did knock down quite a few trees in Atkinson County, did also produce some large hail in Atkinson County, pea up to about quarter size, and it's producing a ton of lightning, torrential rain. This is also a setup. We have so much moisture available today, and these storms are producing such heavy rain. This is a type of setup where you won't necessarily see the tornado coming. You won't necessarily hear it coming. It's going to be hard with it raining and hailing as much as it is with the storm to even hear the tornado sirens if your county has them blaring in the distance. So make sure you have your alerts turned on in your WTOC weather app. If grandma or family member lives down in Bacon County, lives in Wayne County, lives in southern Appling County, specifically, you know, the Georgia 15 corridor just north of Bristol, this spot right here, including the community of Coffee over to Cavill, Scriven, and maybe the south side of Jessup, especially in south of Odom, call them and let them know that we are tracking this dangerous thunderstorm approaching from the south and the west. Does not have a history of producing a tornado on the ground. We don't have confirmation of that yet, but what we can say without a shadow of a doubt here, this has a history of producing damaging wind gusts, knocking down trees, causing some other structural wind damage in Atkinson County earlier this morning. That'll put it in that 50 to 70 mile per hour window and hail up to about the size of quarters. Earlier, the storm was producing hail up to about the size of golf balls as it passed through southwest Georgia. So again, going back to radar here, I'm going to pull up the CC, what we call the correlation coefficient. This is going to be able to help us track if there is any debris or where the hail is. And this blue can mean debris, but I think in this case it is indicating big hail or lots of small hail, potentially lots of pea to maybe penny size, dime sized hail, and some larger stones of hail, maybe up to quarter size or a little bit bigger, between Bristol and Cavill, heading towards Screven. So Screven, you need to have your cars under the carport in the garage, and you need to be in your safe spot because this storm, regardless of whether it produces a tornado or not, will be producing 50 to 70 mile per hour straight line winds and hail, perhaps quite a bit of it, the kind of hail that will accumulate on the ground. And then we'll make piles near your gutters if you have them in your downspouts. A lot of hail, a lot of wind. Those two combined, you know, they can cause damage as well. But it is warned for the possibility of a tornado. So I want to go ahead and jump back to radar, what this looks like in the form of rain. Because remember, what you're watching right now is the measure of the size of particles in the atmosphere. So to simplify that, the raindrops, if there were leaves blowing around in the sky, the hailstones, the radar can detect the size and in some cases the amount of what is up there. And it's saying there is a lot of hail here between Bristol and Cavill, moving off to the east northeast. Jessup, especially the south side, could pick up quite a bit of hail here regardless of whether this produces a tornado or not. Now flipping back to radar, this is a strong line of thunderstorms. This particular storm embedded within the line is capable of producing a tornado. So tracking this off to the east northeast, Doctortown just before 1 p.m. I think Jessup about 12:49, Slover 12:44. Just a few more minutes, it's in Bristol. You're probably already hearing the thunder, seeing the lightning, and the winds might already be picking up even before the hail begins at that particular spot. Looks like we may be having some radar issues there, so I want to go ahead and try to shift over to our Charleston radar site, and it'll give us a little bit of a different vantage point here as we go back to radar as to what we may be able to see. It doesn't look like it's wanting to switch over for me, but this point tells the story as well. You can see this backward C shape. It's a northern end of this, southern Appling County, trying to push into Wayne County that is most dangerous and that is capable of producing that tornado, Dave.
Ham radio operator reporting tornado on Carter Road in Ware County.
Carter Road in Ware County. Okay, so that's going to be...
Ham radio operator.
That's going to be south, so that's actually going to be this storm near near Dixie Union. So that's going to be different than the storm that we're tracking in Applin County and Wayne County, but just showing you that there can be tornadoes. Again, that's an unofficial report, but it was related into the National Weather Service office. You can have little spin-up tornadoes very quickly within this kind of broader area of severe weather, 50 to 70 mile per hour wind gusts and lots of hail. Nasty stuff here, but easily you can have the dangerous stuff spin up within that. That's why we're under a tornado watch. Conditions are favorable for more tornadoes to occur, including the city of Savannah. You need to have alerts turned on no matter where you're watching in the WTOC viewing area. Alerts turned on in your WTOC weather app to make sure you and your family are safe. You have the latest warning. Remember, that's the first step to safety, is have a way to get warning. That second step is have a plan of action to take if your house, your neighborhood, your community is placed under a tornado warning. So going to reset here, going to zoom out just a little bit, let you know that there is a lot more thunderstorm activity just north of this. Not tornado warned, but nasty thunderstorm stretching from near Statesboro. Heaviest weather in Bullock County of this entire event may be happening now, but especially the south end of Statesboro, southern Bullock County. That'll extend on down through Claxton, Evans County, on down through Baxley, Applin County. And it's just one of these southernmost cells and portions of this is going to be southern Applin County, pushing into Wayne County, out of Pierce County and Bacon County. It's this storm that is most dangerous right now. And of course, we do have showers, thunderstorms in the low country. You're probably hearing the rain, seeing the lightning, hearing the thunder, but not severe at this time. The one and only tornado warning we're tracking is going to be south of the Altamaha River. And we were chatting about this morning, and it does look like they've allowed that to almost expire. A tiny little sliver appears to be left there. They may reissue that. We're going to stay with it for a few more minutes.
They're saying there's still a little bit of rotation there, but it's capable of
producing a tornado. Have they said, Dave? And Dave is just off screen here. You may or may not be able to hear him on your TV or on your streaming device at home. Okay, so this tiny little area, they're going to go ahead and leave that up for another 8 minutes, and they may extend this. So Rich, Slover, Jessup, Scriven community, not under tornado warning, but do not to take this with a grain of salt. You need to take this seriously and know that at the very least, 50 to 70 mile per hour wind gusts, hail from peas to about the size of quarters moving in. And what you need to do in that situation is, if you can, if you have time, if you can safely do so, pull your cars in the garage or under the carport. And we are going to be tracking that storm again, moving off to the east northeast. Dave Turley putting his mic on. He's been monitoring chat this morning. Dave, we were talking about this storm for about an hour. We're still watching it as it pushes into Wayne County this morning, but we can pretty much guarantee that this is a severe thunderstorm, regardless of that tornado potential.
Yeah, exactly. And you were talking about that rotation into that storm as well. Still showing rotation in there. They've kind of canceled a part of that warning. So if you're watching over into the Alma area right now, you're okay. It's more on the east and northeast side of Bacon County as it's about to move into parts of the Wayne County area. So as Cutter was mentioning, that warning still in effect here for about the next 6.5 minutes. So if we are continuing to watch that area right here, as we continue to see that possibly producing a little bit of rotation in there. Now, the National Weather Service, as Cutter was saying there, is going to keep that severe thunderstorm or tornado warning through 12:30. The storm is still capable of maybe regenerating some more of that rotation in there, and it certainly is possible. And then if you're continuing to watch right now in Wayne County, this storm is now going to be moving into your area. So as we go back over and we can see the radar on that, we can see the reflectivity of where that storm actually is right now. We're producing a lot of locally heavy rainfall associated with that as it's moving out of the Bacon County area and then heading into southwestern areas there of the Jessup region. Looks like right now the National Weather Service has expired that tornado warning here so far.
We're going to let you go back to programming. Meteorologist Andrew Gorton, Chief Meteorologist Dave Turley, and I here in the Weather Center. They're going to allow this to expire, just not has cleared from our computer system yet. This is still a dangerous thunderstorm, so I want to let you know, we're here. We may send it back to a normally scheduled programming, and very easily they could reissue a warning. Rotation could tighten up once again, and we could be back on your screen here within the next, 5, 10, 15 minutes. So don't think that we're signing off completely and we're going home after this warning is canceled. Conditions remain in place for the possibility of severe weather. Want to go ahead and check in once again, Fair and Fair, our first alert live radar, regardless of the tornado potential, which has at least temporarily lessened. winds and hail pushing into Little Wissi, Jessup, that 84 corridor, down to Scriven, down to Waycross and through Blackshear. This is moving off to the east-northeast. Looking further out in the future, Riceboro, Townsend, and Thalmond could be impacted by this. And we do have gusty thunderstorms through Glenville, Claxton, and into Savannah over the next hour. Again, we'll keep you updated. Please make sure your devices are charged in case the power goes out, and keep alerts turned on in your WTOC weather app. We'll keep you updated here. Next check, if a warning is not issued at 1 p.m., if it is, we'll be back on your screen as soon as it's issued. Stay safe this afternoon.